Hey guys, hope you're doing well. In today's video, I'll tell you about the process for AIPP or the Atlantic Immigration Pilot Program. I'll tell you about the participating provinces, the requirements, how much it will cost you, processing time, and the steps to apply for AIPP. Hey guys, this is Jason from Dream Canada. If you wish to immigrate to Canada or Australia, do visit the channel. I've uploaded a lot of videos to save your money and help you out with step-by-step instructions for your immigration process. Also, I upload videos regularly, so if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, do subscribe now so you won't miss any updates on your Canada PR process. The Atlantic Immigration Pilot is a pathway to permanent residence for skilled foreign workers and international graduates who want to work and live in one of Canada's four Atlantic provinces of Newfoundland and Labrador, Prince Edward Island, New Brunswick, and Nova Scotia. This program has been designed to help employers in the Atlantic provinces of Canada to hire qualified candidates for jobs that they haven't been able to fulfill locally. The total fee for AIPP is around 1,040 Canadian dollars, and the processing time to get your Canadian PR through this pilot program is 6 months. Now let me tell you about the requirements for AIPP. To qualify for this pilot program, you can either be an international student graduate from a publicly funded college or university in an Atlantic province, or as a skilled worker who meets the program requirements mentioned in this video. I'll add a link to the institutions in the description box below if you wish to apply as an international student. For this program, you can be living abroad, that's in your home country, or you can already be in Canada temporarily, but you must have a job offer from a designated employer from the Atlantic provinces of Canada to participate in the pilot. Please note that getting a job offer is very important. I'll tell you how you can find these designated employers and the kind of job offer you need from them later in this video. There are three programs in the pilot that employers can hire you through. You may qualify for more than one program, but you can apply through only one of these. In the first program, which is the Atlantic High Skill Program, you need to have a minimum of 1 year of work experience in NOC levels 0, A or B. Along with all the details mentioned here, you need to have your ECA done from institutions like WES, your language test, and some amount of money collected as settlement funds as well. I'll tell you what these settlement funds are and how much you need in a short while. The Intermediate Skill Program is specifically for those candidates having 1 year of work experience in NOC level C. Here too, you will need your ECA, language test, and settlement funds as well. The Atlantic International Graduate Program is for those candidates who have just graduated from a publicly funded designated institution in an Atlantic province, as I explained before. Even these candidates need a language test and settlement funds as well. Although a candidate applying through the Atlantic International Graduate Program does not need to have any work experience, candidates applying through the Atlantic High Skill Program and the Atlantic Intermediate Skill Program need to have a minimum work experience of at least 1 year, which includes at least 1,560 working hours in NOC levels 0, A, B, or C. As I mentioned before, the candidate must have a Canadian education or an ECA or an education credential assessment equivalent to a Canadian education. You can get your ECA evaluation done through organizations like WES. I made a detailed video on how you can get your ECA from WES. I'll add a link to this video in the description box below. For your language test, a score of CLB 4 or higher is required, which is very less compared to the CLB 7 required for express entry. I've made a video on how you can score well in your IELTS test. I'll add a link to that in the description box as well. The proof of funds or settlement funds required is also much lower compared to the express entry requirement. For instance, if you're a single applicant, you need just around 3,240 Canadian dollars to apply for this program. The most important requirement for this program is having a job offer from a designated employer from any of the four Atlantic provinces. You can find a list of these designated employers on the official IRCC website. These employers must have a confirmation of designation from a province. An LMIA is not required for this program. The job offer must be full-time or at least 30 hours a week, and it must not be a seasonal position, which means you must have your job throughout the entire year. It must also be from NOC levels 0, A, B, or C, and for a minimum period of at least 1 year after you receive your Canadian PR. Your job offer does not need to be from the same NOC level as your previous work experience. After you get a job offer from a designated employer, you need to get a settlement plan. A settlement plan will help you and your family adjust to your new home in Canada by providing you with useful resources and contacts to help you feel welcome in your new community. These plans are completely free and will tell you whom to approach if you ever need any help within the community. You can get your settlement plan from the many settlement service providers listed on the official IRCC website. I'll add a link to the page for these settlement service providers in the description box below. After you've received your settlement plan from your province, the province must endorse your job offer. Your employer will handle this process, so you don't need to worry about this. However, don't submit your permanent residence application until you confirm with your employer that your job offer has been endorsed, as you'll get a certificate of endorsement which you will need to include in your permanent residence application. Your employer will basically fill out and submit an endorsement application on your behalf, which will also include a copy of your settlement plan. Since each province has its own process, your employer may need a few more documents from you, and you may need to fill out a few extra forms depending on the requirements of the province at the time. After all of this is done, you will now have your job offer letter, your settlement plan, and your endorsement letter, which you can now use to apply for your permanent residence through the IRCC website. So guys, I hope you've understood the requirements and steps to apply for the AIPP pilot program through this video. If you have any doubts, do comment below and I'll be happy to answer them for you. If you like the video, hit the like button or share this video with someone you think it might help. Remember to subscribe if you aren't a subscriber yet and hit the bell icon for regular updates on Canadian immigration. Thank you so much for watching. I wish you guys have the best of luck for your application and hope you guys have a great day.